now we're going to combine what we've learned about formulas with what we've learned about clearing the fractions. So you're going to see here that we have some formulas that need to be solved, and we're going to do that by making the fractions go away. And we do that the same way we would if these denominators were numbers. We just clear fractions by multiplying by the LCD. It looks a little scarier in this context, but it's the exact same thing as if these were just regular integers. So for example one, if you notice, our denominator is x, and they ask us to solve for x, which means somehow we need to get x on top. So we do that by clearing the fractions. Where before we would multiply by 2 or 3 or 6 or 12 or whatever, here we're going to multiply by a variable, x. But all the math is exactly the same. We're just going to multiply x all the way across. And if you wish, you can make it a little easier for yourself by writing it as x over 1 for the fractions. You don't have to, but for some people it helps. And so you just see here that I'm taking x and multiplying it by every term, all three of them. So now we will just divide everything out. Nothing divides out here because there are no fractions. And then in the final term, we see the x's divide out. And this is actually considerably easier now because there's only one instance of x left. We just have 5 plus 4ax equals b. And now we just solve this like a typical formula. So we'll subtract 5 from both sides because we want to get x alone. So 4ax equals b minus 5. And then to finish it off, we will just divide both sides by everything that is in the way of x being alone, namely 4a. And so it turns out that x equals b minus 5 over 4a. Example 2 works the same way. Don't let these little subscripts put you off. These are just two different variables. So think of b1 as being like x and b2 as being like y. They have no intrinsic relationship to each other. So what we're going to do is solve for b1. At the end of this, we want to have b1 equals something or other, just like in the previous problem we had x equals. So again, we want to get rid of the fractions, and so we do this again by multiplying both sides by our common denominator, which is 2. And so then, we will just have 2a equals 2 times 1 half hb1 plus 2 times 1 half hb2. And so these divide out normally, and we will just have 2a equals hb1 plus hb2. And again, remember our objective here is to isolate b1, to get b1 by itself. So we continue by getting rid of everything that is not b1. And in this case, that means we will subtract hb2. And you should start to see this take shape a bit. We'll have hb1 equals 2a minus hb2. And we get rid of the h by dividing. And that should take care of that because now we have that b1 equals 2a minus hb2. Divided by h. Now, remember here, some of you will feel a temptation to cross out the h's, but remember, you can't do that, because if you cross them out, you have to be able to divide all three terms by h, and that can't happen, so you don't want to do that. You actually cannot make this problem any simpler than this, so just leave it like that.